Primarily, it is in the area of soy, but we do a lot of other unique types of legumes and beans as well. We take a method of creating higher protein products from those seeds and doing it in a way that is eco-friendly and natural without using any chemicals or putting anything into the atmosphere. And creating products that is turning out to be even more functional than the standards that have been created in the industry prior to this time.
CIRAS is the Center for Industrial Research and Service, but we focus on the small to mid-sized manufacturers in Iowa, the companies that want to grow, that are looking for that outside help, or maybe they're not large enough where they have all the resources internally. They can't afford them, they don't have a person in that area of expertise, and so then they come to the university.
Well, CIRAS has been a critical factor in several parts of what we've been trying to accomplish. It is very important that we provide a product that is safe. So they have been critical in helping train our people about food safety. They've been critical in helping us do just mere safety, OSHA-type safety for our company. They have also been a great resource for introducing us to other entities that can provide. If they don't have the particular resource for us, they're very good at finding other people that can provide those resources for us. And they've done a very nice job with business planning, business continuity planning, carbon footprint planning. All of that relates to our eco-friendly sales marketing effort that we are trying to present. And I can tell you that every large food company manufacturing in the United States are interested in those things because they are trying to do them as well. And thus, CIRAS has really permitted us to be able to communicate that information in an effective way, and thus if we sell our products to these folks, everybody benefits from it.
I think one of the key things that Harvest knows is that they can't do everything internally themselves, and it's a good thing to look to outside resources and other areas of expertise. And they've been willing to invite us in and ask for us to help locate those resources and connect them to ISU faculty, other affiliates of CIRAS, to accomplish their goals. And in turn, it allows them to focus on growth of the company. And so they can enter new markets and add jobs, which is what it's all about. And we're helping them with their operational and business goals.
Actually, it's been an extensive relationship going on for over 10 years. About 10 years ago, Iowa State did some shelf life studies for us. And they're currently redoing those shelf life studies because we have a very large customer who wants more recent data. It was critical back 10 years ago because our processing is different than anyone else's. There was some concern in the industry that our products wouldn't be shelf stable. Iowa State did the shelf life studies and demonstrated that the soy powders that we generate have a shelf life of over 2 years. Took care of the questions within the industry. Doing the same thing now with a new customer, Iowa State's doing the shelf life studies for us. So far the results are confirming what the earlier study was, but again, it's data that this customer, again a very large food company, had to have for us to be contenders in their business as a supplier.
We work with manufacturers who have operational and business needs, and Noel expressed both of those to me, and so we started to locate those resources, the safety being the first one. And we moved on quickly then a couple of years ago as we got to know each other, and they wanted to expand their business and grow into new markets, and the need came apparent that they needed a business continuity plan. And so we coached them through that process and helped them develop their business continuity plan. And the next step came that they needed to do some evaluation of their carbon footprint also for expanding into new markets. So we helped them with that process.
Wouldn't you know, a month after we got done with that training and putting the program together, a very large food company came to us and said, "Do you have a business continuity plan? And if you do, we want you to come and talk to us about your technology." Without that in place, they wouldn't have been able to come to us. That's going to result in growth of probably $7 million over the next 2 years and growing beyond that. And that piece hadn't been in place, so they wouldn't have been able to continue working with us and talking to us. the dialogue would have stopped right there. Normally a concentrate or a soy isolate first is hexane extracted, and then they go some other processing steps. Ours is not. There are no solvents used. That becomes important to certain segments of the market. Places like Whole Foods or Trader Joe's, if you've got a soy isolate that's been hexane extracted, they won't allow it in their stores. So that's been a powerful study for us because it gives a powerful message to our customers that we have an alternative that is not hexane extracted. And we're seeing an awful lot of interest in that alone.
I don't believe people fully understand the depth and sophisticated knowledge that big time universities provide to their states, because it really does allow companies like ours, which is growing at a significant pace, to do a much better job by tapping in to expertise that otherwise we would not have access to, at a price that we can afford because it involves some subsidization from the government, and to make jobs and profits available ultimately to the citizens of the state. It comes back around. So that investment that they are making in large, sophisticated universities is critically important because it ultimately pays off in jobs, growth, more money that is paid in taxes to the state. So I believe strongly that these universities create a real source of information that companies like ours desperately need.